Well, what a game we have in store for you today. The hype has been building all week and the fans are pouring into the stadium. The tension palpable. Stay tuned. We'll have all the action for you live on EA TV. Hello and welcome. The floodlights are shining down here at the 80,000 capacity Lusail Stadium just to the north of Doha. I'm Derek Ray, getting ready to bring you all the action, accompanied by my broadcasting partner Stuart Robson. And both teams looking to get onto a flying start here on match day one for them at the 2022 FIFA World Cup. It's France and they take on Australia.
I'm looking forward to this one, Derek. It's so important that you get off to a good start. So let's hope both sides go for the win here and we get an exciting match.
Here's the side France will go with. Hugo Lloris is the goalkeeper. Raphael Varane plays with Dayo Upamecano in central defence. And up front, Karim Benzema plays alongside Kylian Mbappe. Starting 11 for Australia.
Well, in this shape, they're two holding midfield players will be key today. They can get on the ball and dictate the play, protect the two centre-backs, but will then allow the attacking players to show their creative quality.
To the advanced position. Well, nothing comes of it. It looked promising. Karim Benzema. Benzema. Pavard. Just the challenge that was required. Will France be a hit or a miss? What do I mean by that? Well, when they won in 1998, everything was rosy in the camp, but they were ducked out of the group stage in 2002. They were runners-up in 2006, and then they completely imploded in South Africa in 2010. How about this time as holders?
Well, they've got some great players. They've got an experienced coach. I think they've got good team spirit. I think they're better prepared this time. They've got every chance, first of all, getting through this group, but also going on and winning the tournament.
And after the cross, a tremendous block. Oh, it comes to nothing in the end. Really should have made more of that. Who can he pick out? for that final pass, looking for the goal that would put them ahead. And he cuts inside. A disappointing end to the move. Of defending when it looked as though it might go wrong for them. He doesn't have to do it on his own. Moving the ball forward, what can they do from here? He's got the right idea with that pass. Still an opportunity, and the goalkeeper got there in the end.
Well, his recovery is brilliant here, so athletic.
He's given it away. 1 minute of stoppage time has been added on. This looks promising. And back forwards. And so far the ball. Kick played in. What a struggle to get it away properly. And there it is, the half-time whistle.
Well, who wouldn't want to have Kylian Mbappe in their side? Stuart, a key component of his team.
Well, I thought he had a really effective first half. Not only did he get the goal that gave them the lead, but his general play was really good. He was a constant threat, and I'm sure we'll see more of him in the second half.
Well, it's advantage France after the first 45, but plenty of time for a few twists and turns before this one is over. In a position from which they could potentially do a bit of damage here. A chance for them to provide a test in the form of a corner. Mbappe. Given away by Rabiot. Incisive pass from Mbappe. Oh, he saved it well. And there's the delivery. And the keeper making sure there were no scraps for them to feed on. He's in with a chance. Well, I think you could call that an escape. It looked a certain goal.
Well, as you can see, France have had much less of the ball, but that won't bother them because when they win it in deep areas, they've got forward with pace.
Delivering it,
and the danger's still on.
Mbappe.
Making the goalkeeper's life simple.
That should be hitting the back of the net. That was a big, big chance.
Jamie McLaren. Effective looking pass. He has time to play it over. Just the challenge that was required. Throw-in here for France. And a substitution in the offing. We're inside the final quarter of an hour now. France failing to keep the ball. Hernandez. Tchouaméni. And France pushing forward with options available. It has gone over the touchline for what will be a throw-in. And it is substitution time at this juncture, not just from one side, but from both. Because the flag has been raised. Goodwin. Devlin. It's very effective, good high pressing. What can they produce on the play? Good pick out the teammates. Karim Benzema. It should be! Sure, was punched well away from danger. And that's great work to keep it in play. And the final whistle. And they're going to have to come to terms with this. A defeat, not at all what they were planning for, Stuart.
Well, Joe, it was a hard-fought contest, which neither side completely dominated, but the result will certainly hurt them. They need to bounce back next time out.
And, you know, I think Kylian Mbappe enjoyed himself. Your verdict on his performance tonight?
Yeah, good performance and a really critical goal to give them the lead. They just couldn't cope with his movement today.